The St. Christopher and Nevis Social Security Board has approved a $50 million loan to the federal government for housing development in St. Kitts via the National Housing Corporation, NHC, and a $10 million loan to the Nevis Island Administration for housing development in Nevis via the Nevis Housing and Land Development Corporation. Minister of Social Security et al., the Premier of Nevis, the Honorable Vance Amory, said he put in a request for the loans when he met last week, Wednesday, August 31st, with the Social Security Board.
We didn't go there to dictate to the Social Security Board. We went there with sound proposals, seeking to justify what the benefits would be if the loans are agreed for the development of housing. And let me tell you what we said to the board. The funds made available to the government of St. Kitts and the Nevis Island Administration for housing development will do a number of things. It will enable the government, the federal government through NHC, to engage in the construction of a certain number of houses. But that is not the end of all. It will enable those businesses involved in the provision of building material to have active business and economic activity. There will be a spin-off for those businesses. One, it will enable employment to be increased immediately in the construction of the houses. It will also provide, through people's wages and deductions from those wages, benefits back to Social Security. So you see the whole spin-off effect, which we were able to speak to Social Security about. That is how we want to do things in this country. We want to do it well.
Yes.
We want to do it differently. We want to make sure that any support of Social Security benefits people of this country, not a few.
You can call this housing development initiative the Fresh Start Home Program. It carries the same name as the $16 million EC Dollar Fresh Start Concessionary Loan and Technical Assistance Program for micro, small, and medium-sized businesses. This entrepreneurial loan program, administered by the Development Bank, is set to see an injection of $30 million EC Dollars between now and next year. Thanks to the Team Unity government, 205 successful applicants have already received financing for their businesses. On May 27th, when Prime Minister Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris delivered remarks at the Development Bank's business fair, he addressed the importance of providing financial and technical assistance to the country's micro, small, and medium-sized businesses, as well as housing for the nation's families.
Hundreds of our people have received financial and technical assistance from the Development Bank to develop medium, small, and micro enterprises in high-value areas such as agriculture and farming, manufacturing and housing. Hundreds more who could not qualify for loans from commercial banks have received housing loan assistance from the Development Bank, enabling them to raise a family in a comfortable and dignified environment. Furthermore, many of the loan recipients' children who benefited from the stable lifestyle engendered by an enhanced housing stock have gone on to receive educational loans from the Development Bank. That, of course, will allow them to achieve even greater mobility.
I am Valencia Grant, the press secretary to the Prime Minister.